Hi, it is time to take a closer look at this vase that appears violet at day but blue at night. What is causing this effect? Is white light not just white? Will other types of glass change color too? And what happens if we go a bit to the extremes with the light? Let's find out. Most of the experiments in this video are fairly harmless, except for the shortwave ultraviolet light. You don't want to be in the same room as that. And use laser safety glasses when handling powerful lasers. This vase has an odd behavior. In sunlight it is violet, but under fluorescent light at night it is blue. Here I show it with an incandescent light bulb that mimics sunlight and a compact fluorescent lamp. It will even work with both turned on when there's a barrier between them. The CFL is weak though and not really showing the clear blue color well on camera. Let me upgrade to something more powerful. Now the blue color is more like I see it in real life. Obviously, this isn't a magical color shifting vase, so what else is causing this color change? You may have noticed that even though these two bulbs both are meant to be warm white, they certainly don't have the same color tone. White is not a spectral color, but a mixture of several colors. Let's take a closer look at what colors these bulbs actually emit. I have this direct vision spectroscope. Nothing special, just a tube with a slit at one end, letting light in on a diffraction grating at the viewing end. This will split any incoming light into its spectrum of colors, like a prism will split sunlight into the colors of the rainbow. Let's try the incandescent bulb first. Sunlight is also incandescent, so it's no surprise that we see a rainbow of all spectral colors coming from this bulb. Though unlike a prism, the diffraction grating shows the spectrum several times. The second order spectrum is not overexposed in the camera and is more stretched out, giving us more details, so I'll focus on that one. For some reason, the GoPro is not recording the violet color, but it's not that important for this video. If we switch to the fluorescent bulb, it's a completely different spectrum. It's not a full spectrum from violet to red, but a few distinct wavelengths. When mixed together, these appear white to us, but this bulb is clearly missing a lot of wavelengths, colors. Just for reference, here's the spectrum from a green laser pointer. Not really a spectrum, since this is monochromatic light. It's only green. Now back to the fluorescent bulb. If I put the vase between the bulb and spectroscope, we can see what colors the vase filters out. Do you see that? The yellow completely disappears. The remaining spectrum is what our eye sees as light blue. With the incandescent light, we can tell that some green is also absorbed, but the remaining broader spectrum is what our eye sees as violet or lavender. But what is causing this absorption of colors in the vase? Well, the vase is made of neodymium glass, often called alexandrite glass. It contains neodymium oxide, which I have a sample of here. The neodymium metal ions in this are absorbing the yellow light. It's not a strong effect in opaque powder form, but hopefully you can see it. Now, if neodymium ions absorb all yellow light, what happens if we shine a yellow light on it? In a previous video, I showed this questionable insect-repelling light, which is very yellow. What color will the vase have near this light? Looks like a pale blue-green in real life. Not sure how it looks on your screen. And it actually looks yellow when seeing the light through it. Shouldn't it be more absorbed? Let's check with the spectroscope. Aha! Right away, we can see that this bulb is not only emitting yellow light. For more brightness, it is also emitting red plus green, which looks yellow to us when mixed. I have already shown this with laser beams. Yellow can therefore go through this vase as a mixture of red and green, which fools our eyes. Alright, so my favorite metal, neodymium, has some interesting optical properties. What about some other metals? Here, I have 24 glass beads containing 23 different metals, manganese as two different ions. Let me know in the comments which one of the beads you like the most. The top row looks boring, like normal glass, but only until I turn on the ultraviolet light. It's like night and day. Suddenly, they fluoresce in beautiful colors. Except the silver one. That one needs some more energetic photons to fluoresce. The long wave ultraviolet light from a black light blue tube just isn't enough. I have this germicidal bulb which emits hazardous short wave ultraviolet light, also known as UVC. With me out of the room, UV filter on the camera and a remote control on the lamp, we can safely test if it'll make the silver glass bead fluoresce. Yes, I see some nice dark blue fluorescence. With more normal light, there are still some interesting changes. Here, they are lighted with a compact fluorescent light. Notice the changes as I switch to LED light and white balance the camera. The erbium and holmium suddenly look out of order. Let's examine the beads that change the most in a music montage. The final question is, what happens to the absorbed light? Does it just disappear? No, most likely we are seeing an effect of fluorescence. We usually think of fluorescence as something shiny because we can see the emission part of fluorescence. The fluorescent beads absorb the invisible ultraviolet light and emit visible light. We can't see the invisible light being absorbed, but we certainly can see the visible light being emitted. With the neodymium glass, we are seeing the absorption part instead. The visible light is absorbed and emitted as invisible infrared light. Since we can't see infrared light, we only notice the absorption part of this fluorescence. I wish I had a USB spectrometer. Then I could show the infrared emission and be sure. Click like and comments if you would like to see that. Thanks to all my patrons helping me out on patreon.com. You make a difference when I have to buy stuff for my videos. Interesting stuff tend to be expensive. If you don't want to spend a dollar on my videos, you can still help out for free. Just remember to click like and comment what you thought about this video. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.